So as you can see here, we got our second sheet, part sheet of paper, and we're looking at the top of our model here. This section of the model is what we're looking at here. You can see here we cut the one panel out. We already fitted that. I showed you that. Now we're going to take this panel out here. And again, it's not rocket science here. All we're doing is taking our knife. We're going to cut this out using the ruler. And then we're going to color the edges, and then we're going to attach the model. So hang on, we'll be right back. All right, so we did some cutting out of some of the panels, and I'm going to use this big one for a demonstration. It's a big one that goes underneath the belly of the shuttle. But as you can see here, you can see the, you know, you got this nice color on top, and then on the side you've got the white of the paper showing through. And again, it doesn't look like much here, but when you add it to the model, it really stands out. You can use, like I said, you can use a pencil. Excuse me. You can take a pencil and you can color the edges. You can use colored pencils. You can use pastels. You can use whatever you want to color this edge. For this model, I decided I'm just going to use a plain old Sharpie. All right. The starkness, I think, adds to the weathering of the model, and I'm just going lightly. I don't want to go too much because the marker will bleed through and start coming through. A little bit I'm okay with. I don't want a lot though, but just kind of just basically touching the edges, and that's it. It helps actually that this isn't a brand new marker, because when I first started using it brand new, it bled like crazy on the paper. I had to redo a couple of the pieces. Okay. So that's that, and then we just take it, and we're going to glue it onto the model right there. Just put it right over top of it. Hang on, I'm right back. Alright, so what I'll usually do is I'll take a bottle cap or a water cap. I usually use these for paint and stuff like that. In this case, I'm going to use it for glue. You got your cocktail stick. Use this, you dip it in it, you know, get the amount that you want, and just start painting over the whole thing. Get it everywhere, especially around the edges, but not too much. And I'll help spread it with my finger sometimes, keeping a paper towel close at hand so you can get your fingers clean. Otherwise, you risk the chance of getting glue on top of the model, and you don't want to do that. Okay. So, just keep going, almost done here. Okay, my fingers off. I use tweezers because it gets better. Oops. Let me get to where I need to with this. Okay, so there's where we need to go. Put this in place. a little bit of pressure, and then we got our panel. A little bit of dimension. If I wanted to, I could print it out again, you know, make this, put this ring on here, maybe this whole section here, make this higher than the ring, these square pieces. But to be fair, I'm just not really in the mood to do that right now. But you could. You can keep going and building it up and up and up and stuff like that. So, yeah, it gives you an idea of doing panel work. So, hang on. We'll be right back. All right. So, last we left our Vulcan shuttle, we had our net taped down to the board again, secured in these little paper handcuffs they made and everything. Set it up straight, locked it down, threw it in the shower with the hot steam going for a couple minutes, 3 to 5 minutes. Took it out, let it dry. Did it again, and now we're going to take it apart and let's see where we are. The back end was also locked into place. I just took that off to save some time, but we take this off. We lay it down on the board. And as you can see, hot damn if that didn't work. That's pretty freaking cool. Now, I wouldn't recommend this for every kid. I don't know that it would work. I think I just might have caught lightning in a bottle here and it lucked out. But yeah, that's, she's all even now. And if you look at the back, both the butts are flat on the ground. I'm a little cattywampus on this end here. But, you know, not much I can do. I've learned. Next time I build this, or if I was to build this again, this piece here would have some stiff support in it, whether it was a thicker piece of cardboard or maybe even a sheet of styrene that would help keep it in place and then glue the paper to it. But again, that's live and learn. So, but yeah, that's pretty cool. She's now in place. She's no longer got that cattywampus look to her. And man, that's about it. Let's get some finished shots up here. Hang on. Okay, and here is our Vulcan shuttle sitting on the stand in all its meh glory. The stands are pretty lame on these things, but what are you going to do? But that's pretty much it. I mean, it looks like the shuttle. Would I got better results if I used the plastic AMT model? Sure, but we tried something different. We're doing a little playing around. It's always good to test your skills in different mediums besides, you know? At least that's my feeling. Get out of your comfort zone. As you can see here, we added here, all over. We added different raised panels, which isn't usually a thing of paper models. They're very one-dimensional, so to say, very flat. It's just something I like to do. And actually, I found a forum where the people there are very much into that also, so it's cool. But yeah, all the panels up here were all done. And I don't know if I mentioned it earlier, but let me get in here a minute. All right, there, that's actually a good shot. You'll notice with these raised panels, normally what you do is you cover the edges of your paper when they're cut out. If it's colored paper, everything's colored, right? But the edges of the paper are white because I use a base of white paper. But it would look kind of cheesy with the white showing through. And what the experts will tell you to do is you should always use a pencil or some sort of color. You can use markers and stuff like that to try to closely mimic your base color to add, you know, to hide those white lines, make it look a little bit more realistic. In this case, I went with a black Sharpie on purpose because I wanted the shadows of the raised panels. Is that something I would do it on every model? No, not necessarily, but this one I just felt the black raised lines added, as I always say, points of interest to the model, so I'm pretty happy with that. Some people may not like that, and that's all well and good. They don't have to do it when they do theirs. But yeah, you can see here on the sides, we got these big panels here that were done. Here and here, I think it looks pretty cool. Okay, adds the shadowing and stuff like that. There's some more. So that is pretty neat. Find some place to put this. Again, it's pretty cool. Doesn't mean I won't do the styrene model of it. Like I said, it's just something different to stretch my mind a little bit. But yeah, that's the Vulcan shuttle. I hope you enjoyed this quick run down Papercraft Lane. I will put some pictures at the end of this video, some beauty shots of it. I hope you enjoyed it, and till next time, guys, be strong.